to Indian Defense News. If you are new, please subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when new video is uploaded.
Joint warfare can help the country win wars and save its resources. Vice Chief of Air Staff Air Marshal S.B. Deotade said even as he asserted that mutual trust, character and focus on objectives are key elements to ensure its efficacy. During the inaugural address at the 14th Subroto Mukherjee Seminar here on Joint Approach to Warfare in the Indian context, he, however, underlined the issues of structures and SOPs, standard operating procedures. The subject, joint warfare, is very topical. I will be carrying coals to Newcastle. If I said, a joint venture is essential to winning wars, Deo said. The Vice Chief, who earlier served as the Air Officer Commanding in Chief, RCC, Western Air Command, also emphasized that India is a developing country and thus an integrated approach to warfare can also help it grow. Our defense budget is limited, and India, is not a country that can afford duplicating capabilities. Our resources are limited. And it is in this context that we need to look at joint venture in warfare, he said, adding, the need for the joint venture is also to ensure that defense spend is focused. The YAF will shortly start upgrading the older variants of the Russian origin Mi-17 helicopter, which forms the backbone of the YAF medium lift capability, in collaboration with Israel, by retrofitting them with new generation avionics and navigation aids to enhance their operational capability and enable flights from international airfields. The contracts have been signed and we expect to begin work by March. Air Commodore Sanjeev Sinha, Air Officer Commanding No. 3 Base Repair Depot, BRD, said here today, the upgrade includes replacing conventional cockpit gauges with flat-screen multifunction displays, installation of weather radar, new avionics and communication equipment as well as navigation suites that are compatible with present-day ground-based direction finding aids and instrument landing systems. He added besides Israeli firms, a Bangalore-based private firm is also involved in the upgrade project. About 90 MI-17 helicopters will be upgraded. The YAF operates three variants of this helicopter. The Mi-17V5 came in from 2012 onwards and this variant is already equipped with most of the features, including night vision goggles, which are being considered for the older versions. The Mi-17 can also be armed with external rocket pods and machine guns, and these played an important role in the 1999 Kargil conflict. A new line for overhauling the Mi-17V5 indigenously is also being set up at 3BRD. This will be ready in 2019, by which time the first V5 variants would be due for their first major overhaul, Air Sinha said. An YAF team will also visit Russia later this year for training in this technology. Today, India marks 1 year of the surgical strikes launched on the 29th of September, 2016, across the line of control, LOC, into Pakistan. The event coincided this year with an ambush along the Myanmar border on the NSCNK group, which has evaded talks and has been regularly attacking Indian forces and local civilians. The period leading to the anniversary also included comments by Lt. General D.S. Hooda, who as the Northern Army commander had overseen the strike. His successor, Lt. General Devrajan Bhu, also warned Pakistan that India could again cross the lock if it does not control terror activities. While India recollected the success of the operation, Pakistan continued in its denial mode, rejecting Indian claims. This was expected, as General Hooda had stated. The main worry after the operation was retaliation from Pakistan, but its army denying that the strike took place laid those fears to rest. Pakistan had limited choices, as to admit was to accept failure and demoralize even the cannon fodder jihadists, while lowering the prestige and standing of the army. Denial was logical as the army controls the nation and any setback would damage in reputation. India's curious case of mystery barrel bursts in its artillery guns. Misfires have been reported over the last 5 months into artillery guns, SM-777 howitzers recently delivered to India, and the homemade Dhanush, modeled on the Swedish Bofors. In all these incidents between May and September, the shell did not explode, but it fractured within the barrel before coming out, probably due to pressure. The shell had hit the muzzle of Dhanush's barrel during test fires in May and July. The muzzle, which is on the top of the barrel, was damaged in the incident. A similar incident was reported in the American M777 ultralight howitzers on the 2nd of September. Sources say the damage to M777 was much more severe as compared to Dhanush. The first batch of 25 M777s were delivered by B systems in May this year. Afghan leader thanks India, slams Pakistan. Afghanistan's chief executive Abdullah Abdullah on Friday thanked India for its generous contributions in reconstructing the war-torn nation and slammed Pakistan for its role in destabilizing the country. However, he added, Afghanistan would continue to extend hands of friendship to all its neighbors, including Pakistan.